Welcome back to our channel. In this video, let us see how to plot the knot theory in 3D space using Python program. As we know, a knot is a closed loop of string. It must not intersect itself since that would bring branches, but it may cross over itself. The famous three knots that we are going to plot are trefoil, square and eight knots. To plot it in three axes, we need x, y, z, which are provided by parametric equations, and they are functions of sine and cosine t, where t varying from 0 to 2 pi. Now, let us see our Python code to plot this knot. I have imported NumPy, which provides the numerical functions needed for our execution, like sine and cosine functionalities. And I have imported matplotlib pyplot as PLT. Let us also bring the utility toolkit called mplot3d. This mplot3d gives us the method scatter to plot in 3D surface. So let us create the instance of figure to the variable fig and have the face color set to black. As we want to have the projection in 3D, let us give the projection as 3D for axis method, and the instance of the axis are to the variable ax. As mentioned, t is a functionality which will vary from 0 to 2 pi, and linspace is a method which spreads the values equally. So I am taking 10 samples between 0 to 2 n pi, 2 pi, which will be equally spaced. So first let us print this value of t and see how this t is spreaded between 0 and 2 pi. As we know, 2 pi is 2 times 3.14, and the 10 samples are from 0, 0.6, 1.3, so on until 6.2, as 6.2 is less than 2 times the pi value. Now, with these sample values of t, we can start writing the formulas for x, y and z. First, we will plot for trefoil knot, which, as we remember, is function of cosine and sine t. So x is equal to cos t plus 2 times the cos 2t. Cos function is provided by NumPy package. As we remember, we have already imported NumPy as np. So np.cos times t plus 2 times np cos 2t. This is for x-axis. And let us recollect, t takes the sample values from 0 to 2 pi. Here I have taken 10 samples at this moment. But first, let us plot for 10 samples. In due course, we have to increase this number of sample to get the tube-like image of for the knot. Y, as we remember, y equal to sine of t plus 2 times the sine of 2t, and z equal to 2 times sine of 3t. So with this parametric equations for x, y, z, for the sample 10 samples, let us plot in scatter method. Scatter takes x, y, z axis, and we are going to set the color C to purple for our plot. And we will also give the viewing angle in terms of elevation and azimuth. Elevation is set to 90 degrees and azimuth we will set it to 4 degrees. And let us call the method plot.show, which will show us this scatter plot provided by our utility mplot3d. Okay, we have the error. It's at view init. I think it's it has to be Azim, not Axim. We can see our plot, 3D plot, but since we have taken only 10 samples for t, it doesn't give the not effect. For that, we have to increase the number of samples. Let me take 1000 samples equally distanced between 0 to 2 times the pi. Also, let us make the axis off so that not is completely visible, and set the rectangle space in which this knot is plotted to a color 1D D4AF. We also remember that the actual knot is in the purple color. We got some knot, but I think this is not our intended trefoil knot. Yeah, definitely this is not the intended trefoil knot. Let me revisit the parametric equations. Okay, here in y it has to be sine t minus 2 times of sine 2t. We have to be careful when taking these formulas to get the exact intended knot. Now I hope we will get the trefoil knot. Let me execute it. Yes, we got the trefoil knot. And as mentioned, these knots are good to visualize, and on visualizing it helps us to manipulate the data easily to arrive for any solutions. And we see that they don't intersect itself, but they just cross over. Now we will also do animation in a while so that they will rotate automatically. Before that, we will see the other two knots of our interest, that is square knot and eight knot. Before going to eight knot, let me take the square knot. The parametric equations for x, y, z are functions of sine and cosine. X is 3 times the sine t plus 2 times the sine 3t. Y is a function of cos t, that is y equal to cos t minus 2 cos 3t, as we see here. And as I mentioned, sine and cos are provided by NumPy module that we have already included. We have imported NumPy as NP. So y is NP of cos t minus 2 times NP of cos 3t. And z is cos 5 times the t. And t, as we used in trefoil, it's 1000 samples between 0 to 2 pi, and they are equally distanced. Linspace makes the samples, or picks the samples that are equally distanced between 0 and 2 pi. The other things remain same. It is the same scatter plot of x, y, z with color purple and elevation and azimuth as originally set. We could see our square knot. I'm manually rotating this now with my mouse. Soon we will see how to give an auto rotation or the animation so that it rotates along the azimuth and elevation. Before that, let us make the third knot and the final knot, that is eighth knot. I'm just commenting the trefoil and square knot so that all these formulas are there in one place. Also, when animation is made, once again we can come back and see these knots, how it looks like with animation. Eighth knot, I have pasted the parametric equations for x, y, z. X is 3 times the cos t plus 5 times the cos 3t. Y is same with sine, and z is very complicated. Sine of 5t by t into sine of 3t plus sine 4t minus sine 6t. It's important to write the formulas correctly. Once again, I'm showing the formula for all these three knots that I have used. It shall be through the same scatter plot. We got our eighth knot, and I am rotating this now manually. We can see that they don't intersect itself, but they cross over, and these knots formed a closed loop. Now, to bring an animation, let us import animation from Matplotlib. This animation module provides as function animation method, which gives the functions to rotate itself. For function animation, it needs two functions. First one is init. So the scatter plot will be within init, and this init will return the figure. The second important function is animate, which will change the viewing elevation and azimuth angle by taking the parameter I. So this elevation and azimuth are becoming functionalities of the input parameter I, and this animate also returns the figure. Let us now call animation, which we have already imported from Matplotlib, and take the function animation, which takes figure animate function, and init function here is our init, and this I value to the animate is provided by the frames. Frame 90 indicates that animate I value ranges from 0 to 90, and this animation shall be called at an interval of 100 milliseconds. Once again, let us understand this function animation, which takes the parameters like init function, animate function, and the value for animation provided by frames, and the interval at which this animation has to be called up. This is now getting called through our function animation. As we can see, they rotate along the elevation, because we have made elevation is I 2 times the I and azimuth is 2 times the I. Similarly, we can also give animation to other knots. Now I'll give animation to our square knot. So I am commenting out 8th knot. As we can see, square knot is rotating along both elevation and azimuth axis. Hope you liked the video. Please subscribe to our channel and give a thumbs up.